This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, so we were about to create a accounting entry. So if I go to transaction FB50 and I was trying to provide the document date, posting date, maybe some reference. Okay, and we created two GL accounts. So first one I will debit and second one I will credit, let's say with around 10,000. Okay, so we are debiting the salary and crediting the bank account. Let's press enter. So we were getting this error yesterday and we stopped here, right? So the error is control indicator for controlling S000 do not exist. Okay, which is a common error that you will find in SAP ECC also. But what exactly this error is all about is when you go to configuration of controlling area. So you can see this is our controlling area, which we created as 000. Then you have this activate components and the control indicators. Okay, so if you double click on this, what we have done wrong is we specified the fiscal year as 2019. Okay, so actually speaking, in terms of financial year, we are in 2018. That is the reason system is throwing this error message. So I don't think there is an option to change this fiscal year, but what we can simply do is we can change the posting date, okay, in the transaction. So let's do FB50 once again. Okay, and let's specify the date as, let's say, 01-04-2019. Okay, 01-04-2019. Now I think that error will not come because our controlling area is activated from year 2019. Okay, so I'm specifying the same thing again. So our expense account, and this is our bank account, this is debit, this is credit with around 10,000. Okay, just press enter and see if you are getting that error again. Now that error is disappeared. There is some warning. Okay, so warnings you must be knowing in SAP are displayed with the yellow mark, but here in S/4HANA they change this to orange. Okay, so but this is a warning. Just press enter, that warning will go away and it will throw some another warning. This is also fine. Just press enter. Now there is an error message. So you can see this red mark, and the error is related to the CO object. So whenever we are trying to post anything in the GL, which is also created as a cost element, definitely system is asking you where exactly I should post this amount in controlling. Okay, so you have to provide the cost object. Okay, so we can provide any cost object, but as of now we only created cost center. So just go to the cost center screen and click on start search. So yesterday we created this particular cost center. We will use this, press enter. Okay, there is another error message. Now an entry is required in the value date field of account. This one, this is related to the field status variant which we assigned to this GL account, which has a value date as mandatory field. So I'm putting this as same 1/4/2019. Again, press enter. Now that error messages are gone and system seems to be good with the screen sign. But still, as I told you, there will be a lot of new errors which will come when you try to post this. Let's try to post this now. So this is again the common error. There is no item category assigned to account, which is related to the document splitting functionality. Okay, so let's do one thing. Let me explain you not exactly the entire document splitting, but what you need to do to avoid this error. Okay, so if you activated document splitting by default in SAP S/4HANA, if you are working on the completely new system, document splitting is by default activated. And if it is activated, there is one minimum configuration that we have to do is we have to go to this financial accounting, general ledger accounting, business transactions, document splitting. And here This is a mandatory configuration. Classify GL accounts for document splitting. If you don't maintain this configuration, every time whenever you try to post any document, you will keep on getting this kind of errors. Okay, so let's go to this configuration, classify GL accounts for document splitting. You have to provide your chart of account here, which is S000 in our case. And here, just click on new entries. Provide your account ranges. If you want to avoid again and again coming here and providing one GL account at a time, what you can do is starting from 1000 to 2999. These are our balance sheet accounts, right? So you can select your category, which is balance sheet account. Similarly, starting from 3000 to 3999, which means three series, are our revenue accounts. So I'm selecting this revenue. And starting from 4000 to 4999, this I will keep it as the expense accounts. Okay, so this is the category for expense accounts. Okay, just click on save. Okay, the next time when you try to post this document, this error will not come. So maybe I need to go out, or let's try to post it once again and see. No, we have to go out and try it again. So FB50, sorry. This is the document date. This is the posting date. Let's have some reference. GL account, debit and credit. Okay, system will ask us for value date here. So enter the value date. And here we need to provide the cost center. Just press enter. Okay, again, those common warnings, and then just click on post. So now that error is gone, but this is related to some other error, which is constant Z002 for ledger. This one does not contain any value. Now this error is again not relevant to us actually, and this is not a common error that you will find again and again in the actual system. In this particular system, somebody has made some changes in the document splitting functionality, due to which this problem is coming. So we need to solve this problem. Otherwise, whatever company codes you create, whatever transactions you will do, this will not allow you to go ahead. So what is the problem? The constant 002 for ledger does not contain any value. So simply I'll go to this constant Z002 and I'll maintain some constant values in order to avoid this error. Again, this is related to the document splitting itself. So let's go to this configuration. In the document splitting itself, there is an edit constant. Okay, and we are getting the error for Z002. So let's go to Z002 and maybe mention some of the default values. Okay, so business area, let's keep it as 0001 as default. And segment, let's keep it as anything. We are not worried about this, so keep it this one. If you want to specify the profit center also, just 1 minute. Yeah, this is common, but profit center is according to the controlling area. So let's click on new controlling area, or maybe we can skip this because we don't want, we have still not activated the profit center accounting. So let's save this. Okay, I hope next time we will not get this error. Let's try this once again. So we have to again and again see the error, we have to solve the error, and then we have to proceed. The reason why I'm not all solving all this error first is I want to show you what type of errors you will get and how to resolve them, because these are very common when you will be working on actual S/4HANA implementation projects. Okay, so let's go to FB50 once again. Debit and credit, amount, value date, and cost center. Let's click on post. Just avoid the warning message. Now there is another error. Balancing field profit center in item 001, not filled. Again, related to document splitting functionality, somebody has made profit center mandatory in the document splitting. Okay, and in our case, we have still not activated the profit center accounting, and that is the reason we are getting this error. So let's do one thing. Instead of going ahead with this transaction by changing the document splitting settings, anyways, we need to discuss about the profit center also. So let's do one thing. We will configure the profit center accounting. We will create some profit centers, and then this error will be automatically gone. Okay. So similar to the cost center accounting that we have activated, and then we have created the cost centers, let's do the same thing for the profit center accounting. Okay, any idea where can I go and activate the profit center accounting for my company code? As of now, for our controlling area, profit center accounting is not active. Okay, so where can I go and activate the profit center accounting? This is the same configuration as it was available in ECC. Okay, let me show you. I'll go to SPRO, IMG, controlling. You have this profit center accounting. In this one, go to this basic data and controlling area settings, and then you have maintain controlling area settings. Okay, so this is a place in which, based on the controlling area, you will be telling the system that my profit center accounting is active. So as of now, if I click on this, you can see for S000 profit center accounting is not active. Okay, so if you want to activate it, you have to click this indicator. Now, why it is showing you by 2019? Because our controlling area itself is activated from 2019. If you write there 2018, it will allow you to activate from 2018 itself. Okay, and it is again asking you the standard hierarchy. We already discussed yesterday what is the standard hierarchy in case of cost center. Similarly, in case of profit center also, we have the standard hierarchy. Okay, so let's specify the standard hierarchy here. So again, I'm saying, let's say S000 is my standard hierarchy. There are some other mandatory fields. What currency type I want to use for profit center? So just click on F4. These are the three different options. Normally, we go for controlling area currency. Most of the customers, wherever you will go, you will find that for profit center accounting, they are using controlling area currency. Just click on confirm. Okay, other things are optional. It is not mandatory to enter this. One important thing in ECC, we were specifying the dummy profit centers. Okay, but now in S4HANA, it is not mandatory to specify the dummy profit center. I will tell you why when we will come to that particular point, that particular scenario. So as of now, just remember, we don't need any dummy profit center. Just provide the standard hierarchy, provide the profit center currency type, specify from year indicator active, then only your profit center accounting will be active. Okay, so let's click on save. Okay, Shailendra is asking, what is a store transaction currency? See, there are different currencies. You must be knowing in SAP FI also. You have a transaction currency, which is a document currency. So for example, if you are posting some transaction in USD and then your company code currency is INR. So what happens is USD is converted into INR. So you are, let me write it here. Let's say your transaction currency is USD and your company code currency is INR. Okay, so whenever you do any transaction, let's say I'm doing the transaction for 100 USD, this will get converted based on the rate to something around 6,000, or maybe as of now the rate is higher, so 7,000 INR. Okay, so in SAP FI, we have two different fields to capture this information, right? We have a transaction currency column, and we have a document, sorry, company code currency or local currency column. So in short, SAP is capturing both transaction currency as well as the local currency. Similarly, in profit center accounting, you can have the normal document currency, which is transaction currency, and the currency which you activated just now. You said INR. So normally, if you don't tick on this indicator, in all your profit center accounting reports, you will get the report only in profit center currency. But if you also want to capture the transaction currency information, then you have to tick this indicator. Okay, normally in terms of profit center accounting or in terms of controlling reportings, we are not worried about the currencies. We are only worried about our controlling area currency, and that is the reason this is completely optional, because this is for internal purpose. You got the point, Shailendra? Okay. Okay, so now profit center accounting is active for our controlling area as 000. Let's go and create the profit centers now, right? Just activating the profit center accounting is not enough. We have to create the profit centers also. So in order to activate the profit centers, what we can do is we can simply go to accounting, controlling. Okay, so this is a master data. Again, in the profit center accounting, if you go to the master data, you will be able to see the standard hierarchy and you'll be able to see the profit center groups. Okay, so now if I go to this standard hierarchy, and if you remember on day one, I told you profit centers for this particular company, we are using the example of a chemical company. They have three legal entities. They have different branches, okay, which we can create as business areas. And then within each and every branch, they are manufacturing different products. If you remember, I told you insecticides, pesticides, and fertilizers, these are their kind of products. And within the insecticides, they have different brands. Okay, so for example, let's say our profit centers are those brands. So what we will do is, we will, first of all, we have to change the hierarchy. We cannot create, because it was already created when we created the profit center, when we activated the profit center in the controlling area. So if I double click on change, it will automatically show you as 000. Again, you can add lower levels, same level codes using standard hierarchy, or you can do it via the profit center groups. So it is up to you which one you want to use. Normally for me, I think I find this one simple, but it is not necessary to use profit center groups. You can also use standard hierarchies. So just double click on this, press enter. So here you need to provide the description. So let's say this is my profit center hierarchy for S000. And then within this, I want the lower level groups. So I'll click on lower level. So the first one would be for our company code S001. Okay, same as I created in case of cost center. So this is company code S001. Similarly, I want two same level codes, S002, S0. Just 1 minute, it is stuck. Again, one same level code, which is S003, S003. Okay, and then within this company, within this S001, let's say they are manufacturing two different kind of products. So I'll go for lower level code. And in this one, let's say this is pesticide. I don't know the brands in the pesticide. So let's say this is brand one. Okay, so let's say this is whatever, whenever they are creating, they will be specifying the name of that brand. So this is brand one for pesticides. Okay. Or maybe even what they can do is, before they create the profit centers, let's do this one. This is pesticides. Let's remove this. Okay, create another same level code. This is fertilizers. Okay, and let's say this is another same level code, which is insecticides. Okay, so same way, if you want, you can configure in S002 also. Let's go to the lower level code. Let's say PEST1, this is for pesticides. And let's say this one is only manufacturing pesticides. S003 is only working in fertilizers. Okay, so this has to be unique code, so FERT1 and fertilizers. Okay, so this one is done. Just click on save. And now whatever profit centers you will create under these groups. So standard hierarchy is ready now. Let's go back and create the profit centers. So again, if you want to create the profit centers, you will go to this master data profit center, individual processing, and double click on create. So the profit center, as I told you, I will create it as, let's say, PEST1, which is brand number one under this pesticides. Just click on enter. Okay, and here you have to specify the name. So this is brand one for pesticides. Person responsible, same thing what we discussed yesterday. The manager who is responsible for profit and loss of this particular profit center. So I will specify this as manager. And profit center group, this is nothing but the hierarchy that we just now created. Okay, so we are creating this for pesticide one. This is a group, this is not a description. So we will go with this one. Okay, segment, again, you can specify the segment here. So what we can do is also parallelly is we can create the segments to create the entire end-to-end structure. Okay, so let me show you how to create a segment. Segment is not the company code or controlling area relevance. Segments are created at the client level. So let's go to SPRO, IMG, controlling, sorry. It is in financial accounting itself. Financial accounting, not even financial accounting, sorry once again. It is in enterprise structure. Enterprise structure, definition, financial accounting, and define segment. So just click on define segment. Here you can create various different segments. So my three segments are fertilizers, insecticides, and pesticides. Okay, just click on save. So what does it mean? Why I created the segments? Now, if you go to the profit center, here it is asking you for segment. So this is pesticides brand number one. So all brands combining together, if I want the report, I can specify the segment as pesticides. Okay, so I'll select this. And in case of profit center accounting, just creating and clicking on save is not enough. You have to also activate the profit center if you want to use it. So normally when you click on save, it will just create the profit center, but it will not be active. You have to activate the profit center also. Let's see what are the other things which are available here. Let's go to the indicators. So you can see this dummy profit center is no more available. Lock indicator is available. So let's say you created a profit center for some time. You entered the transactions into this profit center. And later on, you want to discontinue this. So let's say this brand is discontinued, which will not be used in future anymore. And you want to make sure that any user mistakenly also is not able to use this particular brand. Okay, not this use this particular profit center. You can come here and you can lock this particular profit center from here. Also, if you go to company codes, now you can see this profit center can be used for all the different company codes. Normally, if you remember yesterday, can I use the same cost center for multiple company codes? The answer was no. Whenever you are creating the cost center, it will always ask you for which company code you are creating this cost center. But when it comes to the profit center, there is no such restriction in the profit center. Whenever you are creating the profit center, by default, it is active for all your company codes. Okay, but if you have a requirement that you want to block a particular profit center for a particular company code, you can come here and you can deactivate this. So in our case, we are creating this profit center only for company code S001. So only company code S001 would be able to use this profit center. Even mistakenly also, all other company codes are blocked for posting anything in this particular profit center. Okay, address information is again the same, where you can specify the address of the person who is actually handling this profit center. Normally we don't maintain, or even if you maintain, this is normally the address of your company code itself, because normally we don't have the separate address for the separate profit centers. Communication, who is responsible, what is the telephone number, what is the fax number, you can specify here. And history is just to give the report, who created this profit center, who has changed this. So the complete trail you'll be getting in this history tab. Okay, so let's say yes, Akash,
please go to indicator tab.
Indicator tab. Okay,
what is the formula planning?
Formula planning, as I told you yesterday, that this is related to the planning of this profit center. Whenever you want to plan, see, you are creating the cost centers and profit centers in order to capture the actual postings. But what you can also do is you can plan the postings into profit center at the beginning of the month. For example, normally these companies, they plan what would be my profit for this particular quarter or for this particular year. So that planning can be entered using the figures. So for this particular quarter, for this profit center, we are expecting this much profit. And then you compare your profit, planned profit, vis-a-vis actual profit in the reporting. So in order to have that planning, you can provide the template here, like how exactly my planning template will look like. So we will talk about this when I'll show you the topic where we'll be planning for the profit centers and the cost centers. Even this particular thing was available yesterday also when we created the cost center master data. Even there also you'll find this formula planning template. Okay, Akash. Okay, so let's, if you want to save as inactive first and then on to activate, that is also fine, but it is better to just click on activate. So it will be saved and activated at one single click. Okay, so now this profit center is available and we can now go back to our cost center, okay, which we created yesterday. So if you go to our cost center, which is, I can go to transaction KS02. KS01 to create, KS02 to change. So this is the cost center that we created yesterday. And this one, if you want to assign it to the particular profit center, we can directly assign here. But now let's try to understand the combination. Okay, because when we are saying profit center is assigned to the cost center, there has to be some logical way in which the profit center is assigned to the cost center. Okay, so this cost center is for S001. Okay, and this is for the Bangalore unit. Okay, but we are not specifying here within the Bangalore unit, this cost center is for pesticide, or this is for insecticide, or this is for brand one or brand two or brand three. Okay, so in that case, what we can do is actually, when we created a profit center, we will create one more profit center, which is KE51 transaction to create a profit center. Now this time I will create S001 CMN, which means common profit center for S001, which will not be specific to the particular product. Okay, so if I press enter now this is my common profit center for S001, which has nothing to do with the products. So this is our common for S001. Person responsible, again I am keeping is manager. This profit center group, I will select S001 level. Okay, so this is my common profit center for S001. So I will select this. And segment, again, there is no proper segment. So even I can create a segment which is a common for all, or simply I can keep it blank. If my segment reporting is not mandatory, I can keep it blank. Okay, or otherwise it is always better to even create a segment which is common. Okay, again, you can create this common segment for S001, S002, and S003. So this would be common, or maybe we can just name the same thing, S001, S002, and S003. So why are we creating this common? Can anybody tell me why are we creating this common cost centers, common profit centers, and common segments? When are this required? Any idea? Anyone?
I think for intercompany related transaction, we can use these things.
Intercompany related. What else? Many times. Sandeep, can you mute yourself? Yes. See, this one we created for admin department of Bangalore S001. Right? We created this cost center for Bangalore department for company code S001. Now, in this case, whatever cost is admin cost, is it segregated by insecticide, pesticide, and fertilizers? Let's say, for example, you have a factory. Okay, and in that factory, you have an admin department. In that factory, you are manufacturing fertilizers also, pesticides also, insecticides also. So let's say for the factory, you are paying rent. Now, will this rent be divided by fertilizers, insecticides, and pesticides, or your supplier will give you the common later, common invoice of the rent? He will give you the common, right? He will say that factory, you are using the factory, whatever you are manufacturing, I don't know. You are using this factory and you need to pay the rent of this much. Now, when you are booking the invoice for this rent, even you are not able to segregate between pesticides, insecticides, and fertilizers. You have to book this as common cost because it is used by all the different profit centers. And later on at the month end, you can decide how much percentage should be divided in each. Okay, and that is the reason we create a common cost center and profit center, because when we are booking the cost at that time, we may not be knowing where exactly this cost will go. Okay, and that is the reason we need to create a common. Normally, even if you see any customer's environment, at each level in the hierarchy, they create one common cost center. The idea is that you don't know where exactly this amount should go. But at the month end, you will remove all the costs from that common cost center and you will allocate to the respective cost centers and profit centers. You understood this point? Okay, let me explain. I'll explain this once again. So profit center, I will now select here the profit center as S001 common. Okay, and click on save. There is some message. Field changes to field profit center lead to complicated taste of the data involved, which may take some time. Do you really want to carry out field changes online? We will say yes. Okay, so it is done. Now let me explain what I was saying. See, you have three. Let's again understand our structure. So in our company, client is having three companies, three legal entities, which we created as company codes. which are those S001, S002, and S003. Now, he is manufacturing three different kind of products, three product lines, we can say. Three product lines. What are three product lines? Is manufacturing three product lines. Number one is insecticides. Number two is pesticides. And number three is fertilizers. Okay. So these three legal entities we created as company codes. These three product lines we created as segments. Now within this segments, within insecticides, there are product one, product two, or instead of product, let's say brand one, brand two, and brand three, for example. These are profit centers. Apart from this, they have three different locations. Okay, so these three different locations are Bangalore, Pune, and Mumbai. So this we created as locations, we created as business areas. Or if you are not created, we will create them. I think we already created. So three different locations are created as business areas, three different product lines are created as segments, and these brands are created as profit centers. Now, let's say you are booking rent for Bangalore unit. Okay, now you are booking the rent for the Bangalore unit. Can you tell me this rent of this Bangalore office will go to insecticide, pesticide, fertilizer, or it will go to brand one, brand two, and brand three? Whenever we are booking the rent, we are not sure, right? We will book this. This is common. Bangalore unit is common, which is used to manufacture insecticide, pesticide, fertilizer, each and everything. And that is the reason whenever we are booking, we will book in the common cost center. First, it will go to the common cost center. And then afterwards, from common cost center, it will be allocated to respective cost centers later on. Okay, similarly, it will go to common profit center, which will be allocated to proper respective profit centers later on. Similarly, common segment. Okay, so this is the purpose of creating the common cost center, common profit center, and common segment. So at each level, we have to create the common cost centers, common profit centers, and common segments. Okay, that is exactly what we have done here. So if I again go to this cost center, now in this one, I have not specified the business area, whereas this is for Bangalore. Okay, so I should specify the business area also as Bangalore in order to make sure that whenever I am posting anything in this, if I go to the business area Bangalore, it will give me the complete information of what is the expense for the Bangalore unit. Okay, so as of now, this is into the profit center common, because we don't know whether this is pesticide, insecticide, or brand one or brand two. So anyways, as of now,